episode 9 is said to insert many different pieces of Jedi and Sith lore into this story by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, what's really exciting about this film so far is that J.J. Abrams is going to use this movie as a way of connecting it to the prequels and the originals, specifically, of course, by also adding in a lot of Jedi lore in order to really move the characters like Rey and Kylo Ren forward in this story. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film when it comes to some of the set leaks, the set designs, the concept art and storyboard descriptions, etc., one of which has all to do with Rey, the first Jedi, and the first Jedi's identity in episode 9. Specifically, it's described that one of the large set pieces that were used for a scene with Daisy Ridley included a large statue that is said to be of the first Jedi. It's described that it stands around 25 feet high, where the statue set piece was dubbed as Master Nalar. It's said that the piece took around 1 month to build prior to filming for the movie, and is based off of a Legends Jedi character that will be inserted into the Jedi lore under Disney. Additionally, a concept art description describes Rey holding an ignited blue lightsaber, creating a blue hue against the statue, with Rey looking up at the face of the statue, where the sequence is described as Rey's discovery of the statue of Nalar. It's said that the first Jedi held many names throughout the ages, however, it's described that this is the character's true first and or last name in episode 9. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this. Now, the statue is described to be in or around 25 feet high. Now, that to me is a tall statue that will be used within the Lost City scene for episode 9, where Rey, by the way, discovers a lot of Jedi, you know, secrets and Jedi lore and stuff like that. And as well as new secrets that are connected to other characters like Ezra Bridger and Ahsoka Tano, like certain artifacts that they left behind within the Lost City. And it really does make one wonder what the meaning of the name Nalar is. Now, it's spelled N-A-A-L-A-R. So the statue is actually dubbed as Master Nalar, and this is described to be the character's true first and or last name in episode 9. So Master Nalar, I gotta say, it sounds somewhat Jedi-like. I'm not quite sure, you know, if we have ever had a Jedi name like that before in the EU and or Legends material. However, the thing that really does pique my interest is that the first Jedi himself, the statue, the character, is actually based off of a Legends Jedi character, alright, the expanded universe, if you will, that is going to be a part of episode 9. So already we can see what Chris Terrio is doing. By the way, guys, in case you guys did not know, Chris Terrio is pretty much well informed on a lot of the EU slash Legends stuff when it comes to Star Wars, and that he had a big hand in incorporating a lot of the Legends material in Star Wars Episode 9. So this Master Nalar character, the first Jedi statue, in case you guys did not know, we went over this a couple of times, where the statue actually does hold a great power for Rey. When she touches it, she learns new abilities. She even hears certain voices of the Jedi code that makes her pretty much attracted to that statue, and she goes toward it. Very similar to what happened with the Tree Library on Ahch-To. You guys may recall, she was hearing voices on the planet, and she eventually turned around and saw the Tree Library leading her over there. So this whole entire sequence, where she's also wielding the Anakin Skywalker lightsaber, the blue one ignited in front of the statue, creating this blue hue against the statue itself of the Master of Nalar, it can really only make one wonder exactly what Rey is really searching for in the Lost City. Now, just a couple of hours ago, we went over how Anakin Skywalker actually leads Rey beneath the actual Lost City, basically, you know, another whole entire level of the Lost City underneath the Jedi runes that leads to a meditation place, like a meditation room of some sorts, where Rey is actually able to see moments of the past and the future. But back to the Master Nalar statue, guys, I gotta say, I mean, I really do hope that we get to learn more about this character, either in the form of a book or a novel, maybe even a comic, if you will. I think that's what Disney and Lucasfilm should do, at least with a lot of the canon material, is explore a lot of the ancient Jedi and ancient Sith that is currently, you know, pretty much unexplored in the Star Wars lore. You know, in the EU, we knew a lot about it. We knew a lot about Darth Nihilus, we knew a lot about, you know, Darth Malgus, you know, Darth Malak, all these different Sith lords, thousands of years prior to the events of the prequel trilogy era. And I think that's exactly what they are trying to do, since they do plan to do an Old Republic trilogy. However, that's going to be set hundreds of years before the events of Episode 1 instead of thousands. But I digress, guys. Master Nalar, I kind of like the way it sounds. It sounds somewhat like a Jedi or somewhat like, you know, a Sith as well. It sounds more something like a Qui-Gon Jinn type of figure, somebody who follows the Jedi code, but doesn't necessarily follow it completely. But when we look at, you know, Rey and her journey in this movie, we do know that's the main reason as to why JJ is using the Jedi lore in the stories, because he's using it as a way in order to push the character forward on this quest of hers that she actually goes on beneath whatever surface that she, you know, of whatever planet that she's actually on, beneath whatever surface that is within the actual Lost City itself. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.